Hello everyone, my name is Ariana Drivdahl and I'm with Moxa Americas. There is a growing need in the industrial space for long-distance communication, which also supports high bandwidth. Some examples of where that might be used would be remote video monitoring of a water tank in a water-wastewater facility, or something like communication to an offshore oil platform for oil and gas. Here's the problem. 900 megahertz systems, which are traditionally used for long-distance communication, have a very low bandwidth. Wi-Fi, on the other hand, tends to be very high bandwidth but can only go very short distances. And backhaul communication, which can combine both of these, is very, very expensive. Today I'm going to show you a new technology from Moxa that can address all three of these points. And I'm here on the rooftop of Moxa's U.S. headquarters here in beautiful Brea, California. Typically, Wi-Fi will have a range of around 300 meters, assuming a good line of sight. That's about the distance from here to the edge of our parking lot. So today, what we're going to be demonstrating is taking this technology and establishing a wireless link between our location here and those homes that you see way off on the hill, which is about 2 kilometers away. Once we're there and establish that communication, we will be streaming a video link across the two units. The way that we're going to demonstrate this is using this setup that we have here. We have one of our cameras, which is connected to our AWK3191, that's the actual wireless unit. It's connected to a 5 dB directional antenna. On the other end, we have another 5 dB antenna, which is connected to another AWK3191, which has a direct wired connection to our laptop here. The laptop is now streaming the video that's coming through from that camera. So now we're going to take this camera, and I'm going to drive up to the hill that we showed you a little bit earlier to show you how that actual video transmission will work. So let's go. So here we are at a remote site. We've powered up the unit that you saw earlier and pointed our antenna straight back at the Moxa building, which you can see off in the distance. Once we have done that, we are now streaming video across our live 2 kilometer link. So, hello everybody. This is a live video. As you can see, this has not been pre-recorded. We are actually streaming in real time across our 2 kilometer link between here and the Moxa office. We've been able to achieve this by taking a standard Wi-Fi radio and frequency shifting it down to 900 megahertz. We call this frequency shifted Wi-Fi, and let's take a look at how it works. Standard Wi-Fi operates at 2.4 and 5 gigahertz and has a channel width of 20 megahertz. The shorter wavelength of Wi-Fi tends to limit the communication distance that it can cover. Typical 900 megahertz installations will usually have a channel width of around 5 megahertz, which will drastically limit the amount of bandwidth that is available for use. The benefit of 900 megahertz is that the longer wavelength will actually give you a much greater communication distance than standard Wi-Fi will. Frequency shifted Wi-Fi, on the other hand, really combines the best of both worlds. We can take the 20 megahertz channel width that we associate with traditional Wi-Fi and add that to the longer wavelength that is seen by 900 megahertz communication, which allows us to have both long distance and high bandwidth at the same time. Another benefit to frequency shifted Wi-Fi is that it is a very suitable alternative to traditional Wi-Fi in environments where the wireless spectrum already is oversaturated. We've tested this technology in the field using high gain Yagi antennas. At a distance of 30 kilometers, we were still able to obtain a usable throughput of 6 to 7 megabits per second. This innovative technology is available on our new AWK3191. If you would like to learn more about this or any of our Moxa products, please visit us on our website at www.moxa.com or simply give us a call. I'm Ariana Drivdahl, and thanks for watching.